actually more likely to fund things like this. So if you go for the big ones, they want to associate with something that's really polished. So fringe is not really going to fit into it.
You want something with local flavour and with a, yeah.
You want somebody who's built their business in your teams, ideally.
Yeah. You can link with artists as well, in terms of selling your artists on or split some money with them. We've had corporates where they wanted to meet and greet with the artists afterwards, and as long as the artist's okay with that, and sort of split the money. Or something. Yes. So that stuff's up for grabs.
Can I ask how long it took to develop
a
relationship with
Nielsen
to get that investment?
I've been trying to get sponsorship for 3 years, and I lined up someone else that fell through a week before we sort of had to sign up last year. And then Nielsen came aboard. We started in December talking to them. They didn't know what they wanted to do, but they wanted to be involved in something. And it took a very long time. They had their own agenda and they had their own bits of kit. They had some virtual reality snowboards and stuff like that. But my friend's got the Warren. It's an English country garden. It's got bunting and fairy lights. And, you know, it doesn't quite fit with that high octane stuff. So balancing the brand so they didn't feel like an add-on, felt like it took a long time. We did it at the festival in May, so from December leading up. It's really long, so they need the decision making late, so quite, some people decide in January.
So for the recent big outdoor Clash of Drums event, I brought in £20,000 for sponsorship. I have never worked so hard in my life for £20,000. I kept wanting to just say, should we just leave it? I won't use your £20,000, I'll make a saving somewhere. It's hard work to sponsor.
It's really hard work, and we automatically become the subservient with the arts and stuff like that. Actually, towards the end of that relationship, I should stop saying the company name, it's too late now. It was going, no, this is what's going to work. You need to reach people, so we're going to need it. And then it was less work for us. But it's really, that was just a lovely bit. It's really hard work running businesses. Mm-hmm. If you're small, you can get little bits of money here and there. There's various funding pots around that are useful. I work with young people a lot. We tap up O2 Think Big, which is a £300 microfunding scheme, and all sorts of bits like that.
We're having a discussion about funding over there a bit.
Yes.
There's three here that I think you want to get quite a bit. How do you think Fringe best supports producers?
Producers make supportive work in venues or
producers both. Producers who are putting on things and creating new work, not just the artists but the actual co-directors.
Yeah. I think
just getting to repeat the question, so I'm not sure how to hear that.
Sorry, we did have a microphone system, but then I thought we would ditch it.
Do you want to?
If you stand up, then you probably can. Come on, Jeff.
I think it's that beyond the network. So producers and directors are very good working together, making work, like making it happen. But there's opportunities to find a suitable venue or to market their show or to link them. If you're doing Fringe showcase, really, so you want to be present work here and get them to see it, which is great, but also you want promoters to see it and press to see it. And it's the Fringe organisation has that power, that mass power, to go and get those people to town. So trying to invite people who might take your work on further. So if there's a network of theatres or some international promoters who are nearby or persuade to come up in July, so it's that job of just networking them all across. So the Fringe is at its best in Brighton when Julian Lundgren pulls me by the shoulder and goes, come and meet these guys or stuff like that. So that sort of wider networking was really important. But also to mitigate risk and to say when something's maybe not the greatest idea in the world or not letting someone fail, so not holding back on creativity, but going, what a great opportunity, but don't put it over there, it's not going to work, let's find you somewhere here. And you can up ambition, I think, as well, and that's such a persuasive encouragement. And dollar, if you've got any money, they like money as well. I think that's okay. You can't grow if you've got that one-to-one, you're supporting every production like that. You need to have a participant services brain on that you can help them find the right space, and then support the festival as a whole, much wider support as it comes up. You've got the ever possibility of being a huge festival and Cambridge. You've got the right people, a big city, you're the right distance away from sort of other things that can distract people. You should really be pulling in people locally into NK, so they should be coming in here to be part of your fringe and to experience your fringe. I think that's your next, I don't think far off. Utilise your network. It's really hard for you to do it on your own, but if you drag Jess with you, and I don't know your name, sorry, from the council,
Lucy.
Lucy, sorry. Get Lucy or someone from Milton Keynes Council to get down there, and then you can get those sort of shared voices that will help you push through and knock those down. They don't always open, you know, you've got to bang a few to get the right one. But there's a lot of using space in different ways is very interesting, and I think people just don't see the potential all the time. I think art is your best place to go. This could be that. It's not really expensive. I mean, the Warren, it's expensive, the Warren, but you know, it's amazing what we do with fairy lights and festoon lighting and some bunting. And we got away with making some big events, which we just all clubbed together and spent the weekend making, and suddenly it looked like a country garden. You know, you don't have to be too high end about it. Homemade is encouraged. Also, if you're being reviewed and you get professional reviews up on these websites, then it will print them next to your listing, which is quite good. The trick with Fringe, and what I love about Fringe, is I go to theatre quite a lot, I work in theatre, but I go for one show a night, and in Fringe, to encourage one to try and get someone to go to three things in a week, or five things in a week. So even though when you've got them and they come to see two things, and actually you go next time, come back and see four. So an app gives you that immediacy. It's a changing people's headspace to go, I booked for something in 3 weeks' time, and they'd be sat at the bar and going, oh, that's on in half an hour, let's go see it. Mm-hmm. That sense is really important. Mm-hmm. So iFringe, I think, is really good. Twitter can be used very well. But, yeah, so I think apps are good if you can encourage them to use apps. Do you have a central box office?